Yeah, your man DJ Silver Night Party Fanatic, you know how it goes down. Another one. We're going to keep this thing going, keep bringing you this great content, great people, good food. We're back at Cole on Highland. I'm with my brother, super manager to the stars, booking agent to the stars, and just an all-around great guy. My man, Johnnie Cabbell.
Yeah, I am in the building.
What's up, man?
Man, I'm blessed, man. I'm happy to be alive. Yeah. You know, we about to go into a new millennium.
Yes.
I'm just excited about a lot of things, and I'm excited about being here on this podcast.
I'm excited about having you, my brother.
Listen,
I'm glad you picked up that phone. You always pick up the phone for me.
Hey, that's how I've been able to be in the game and stay consistent for 20 years.
Wow.
You know, I'm coming up on my 20-year anniversary.
Wow. Let's go and hit that again. Hit that.
Yeah.
Damn. Yeah. 20 years, Johnnie?
20 years in the game, doing it big. And just been getting blessed over and over and over.
Wow.
And just staying relevant out here, man. A lot of people don't make it 20 years.
Yo, for real. They don't make it 2 years.
One. So, you know, it's a blessing, man. It's a blessing.
That's dope. Well, look, we're going to get into a couple questions today. We're going to hang out, kick it, eat some food.
Man, listen, you know, I returned me onto this new sushi roll.
Hey.
So, hey, I'm like, wow.
But first, whiskey. But first, whiskey.
Okay.
Hey, Am. Go Am. My homegirl Am, y'all, what's up? My nephew back there. Nephew, you got everything recording? You know, this be, you know, bootleg. It's the best looking
Am
bootleg
taking
operation.
Care of us up here.
Ooh,
today.
I said half a shot. You see you playing.
Ooh.
Oh my God.
Am trying to make sure we
get
right.
Oh my. But first whiskey.
Yeah, salute.
Here we go. Oh yeah.
That's not bad.
That's
not bad.
Which one is that?
That's some good whiskey right there.
That's good whiskey, young boy.
Good whiskey.
That's that Suntory whiskey, that Japanese. Woo!
Woo!
I'm sweating, though. Okay.
Save me some of that. Well, I'm finna come out of the jacket in a minute.
Bruh. Oh, I'm gonna be in a tank top. And whoa, hold on, y'all.
Come out the jacket.
You still got the heat on? Open the doors up. Oh, I forgot. What are we doing? Oh, it's a podcast. Okay.
Yeah.
Jesus. I had questions. I had a couple a minute ago. So first things first. You got a real history in music.
Yeah, yeah.
You used to sing or something?
Oh, you did your homework. Oh, shit. What the hell did I just walk into?
Oh. Well, now that's funny.
I actually was part of a group called Intake.
Okay.
And we
R&B group.
Yeah, R&B group. And we was with this label called 40 Street Records.
Okay.
It was actually was us, Rashida,
food.
My boy, Skinny Pimp. I bet you don't remember Skinny Pimp. But from Memphis.
Yeah.
Skinny Pimp back in the day, Skinny Pimp. So
and Rashida.
Rashida, she was on the label.
Dope.
And it was another group. But we did this compilation. We was touring, going all around the world and everything.
Wow.
We ain't know nothing about the business. And I had somebody pull me to the side and, you know, start educating me and put me up on game. And I'm going to be honest with you, I kind of found my niche for being behind the scene and like, oh, this is where I need to be at.
You liked it better.
You found your calling. Forget being on the front line. I need to be on the line with the money coming in at.
That's the real money,
So, you know,
money,
I just started getting into the business side and kind of found my niche. And
oh, man, we ordered all this food? Jesus.
What food that is?
That's the, come on, bring it in there. That's the mango summer roll.
Mango summer roll? I like that.
Nephew, you want to try it, don't you?
Well, we got some. Hey, well, I need to come to your podcast once a week. I can eat good coming to you. But I didn't even want to pull out my phone. I don't know if I'm being ratchet or not.
No, do it.
But man, they got to see this. This is how you treat a brother when you come. This is how you treat a brother when you come to a podcast.
Nephew. Can you check?
Hey, man, y'all see this? This is how you treat you, bro. You
That's
got the boy Silver Knight.
Hey, man, we here.
We're on a podcast. You know, we keeping it so real that we doing everything.
Yeah, we doing everything.
We just, you know what I'm saying, going with the flow.
Yeah.
Going with the flow.
But look at the spread.
What is this right here? What is this?
That's
again?
The mango summer roll.
Mango summer roll.
Malaysian chili wings. And I believe that's the tiger.
That's the tiger roll.
You want to try the tiger.
And we had that.
Bring that other one over here.
Ooh, that whiskey.
Yeah. Oh, the whiskey?
Yeah. that whiskey right there is on point.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know,
that was, that's a new roll. That's the Thai salmon roll.
Thai salmon roll.
So good.
Yeah, I just found me a new roll. But yeah, man.
Look at this spread. Oh, my God.
This spread is crazy. Yeah. We had this podcast, and I'm just letting y'all know that it's going down real big. Me and my boy.
Live on the podcast.
Live on the podcast.
We're actually filming right
like,
now.
Like, we filming doing this right
I'm
now.
I'm letting this whole thing play.
You know what I'm saying? Shout out my, shout out the Lifestyle. They blessed me with, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, that's dope.
They got a
So tell
nice
me about
clothing.
Lifestyle. That's the clothing
Lifestyle
line?
Lifestyle got a nice clothing line, and they've been doing their thing. I am like the ambassador.
Okay. That's a nice
Lifestyle.
Jacket,
they got, their clothing line is on point.
Okay.
Shout out to my boy Ramsey. He been doing it real big.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You're going to have to bring him up here.
Okay.
Because he, you know, he had his own TV show.
Mm-hmm.
He clothing line. He ain't done a lot of stuff,
okay.
But he'll be a good brother for you.
All right, hey, link us up,
Ramsey. I'm gonna link you up with my boy Silver Knight. It's done.
It's done.
I'm bring you on so you can talk about Lifestyle. Now I know I'm finna get me a package. I need my package together right now.
I need at least a tank top for this.
Yeah,
shout
we gotta
out.
Get, hey, yeah, we gotta get my man some because
a
about
belt
to,
or something.
Yes, gotta get him straight. Gotta get him straight.
So Johnnie, check it.
Yeah,
you've had your hands in some pretty big projects over these 20 years, brother.
Man,
Gucci Man.
Well, let's before we get
let's,
to Gucci
before
man,
Gucci,
Crime Mob.
Crime Mob, that's right.
D4L.
D4L.
Shawty Lo.
Shawty Lo. My
Fabo.
Boy. Fabo.
Shot
keep going.
Boy.
Keep going.
Trivial. Scrappy.
Keep going.
Who was that before? Oh, even before then, I was messing with Q from ESC. We had a big single that
yep,
I was singing
yep.
the hook on. He had this song called Know That. And
you
Greg,
know I'm gonna find it,
Greg,
right?
Greg was the first person to spend money with me. He licensed the wow. song and never even really used it. But he liked, but I was singing it hook and it was like, we don't meet side the niggas for show that them big head presidents. We fold that, they're like green hydro. We roll that, we ballin' out control, niggas. Know that. And
hey, you can release you can release that right now. You can release that right now. You can
song
say okay,
was crazy.
So you can sing for real.
Yeah, I do a lot of some. You know, I do a lot of some.
Sing for real. Who that ringing? That you ringing back there? That's you. Who that ringing? That's your other phone.
Oh. Man. I didn't even put that phone out. I didn't even.
Excuse
know.
Me, now say what?
Man, they're going to have to call. That is crazy that my phone. Listen,
so,
I am on a podcast doing it.
Who that? Who that? Who that
so
is?
Whoever this is.
Who that is?
Me, please call me back because you just interrupted my interview. Let me put this phone
I love,
on silence.
I love how bootleg my shit is. I love it. My shit is
hey,
so brutal. We done took calls.
It don't get no realer than that.
It don't get no realer.
And,
but that's what it's supposed to be.
I apologize for that because, I mean, that was just totally out of line.
Oh, man.
Now, tell my man, I ain't know this phone was going to go off. So
listen,
that kinda,
I'm about to jump in here. You trying to be cool. I'm about to jump in and get some of this mango
yeah,
roll.
Yeah, you get that while I get this phone on side.
So,
So,
you left out Nikki.
Oh, no, I didn't even get to that part.
You didn't get there.
I didn't get to that part of where we got, you know, when I teamed up with Deb Atney. Shout out to
yep,
Deb Atney.
Yep, mm-hmm.
And started working with Deb and... No, we did Nikki, mm-hmm. we did Gucci, mm-hmm.
Walker,
OJ. I mean, like, I really been behind a lot of people.
You used to bring a lot of them through primetime all the time
yes,
when I was
yes,
DJing there.
Yes, 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 yes.
Yeah, we go back
I brought
to primetime
Nikki,
days.
I brought
now.
Nikki to primetime.
Yep.
I remember bringing Nikki to primetime.
Yep.
And I took Nikki from like zero to like $100,000
mm-hmm.
within
mm-hmm.
like a year and a half, you know. So, you know, that was like one of my biggest accomplishments, working with a female and actually breaking a female and getting them to that type of money and everything. And then it just started rolling downhill from there, like, you know, Cash Doll
mm-hmm.
and,
mm-hmm.
you
mm-hmm.
know, I got
mm-hmm.
Light Skin Keisha mm-hmm. currently now. I just did a deal.
You got L.A.?
Young
mm-hmm.
L.A. Just did a deal.
Congratulations,
with,
man.
Yeah, just did a deal with QC and I
mm-hmm.
Signed a female artist, Leighton Green. Me and my partner, Prophet, we manage her. And she got the number one song on the urban charts right now.
Very good.
You know
what
I'm saying?
Good.
Radio. So she been doing her thing, doing her thing.
That's dope.
And with number three, Rhythmic. So... You know, we've been moving along. And I got this other R&B artist, Kissy Lee, that's
Kissy
doing
Lee.
Her thing. And Fly
who
J.
Who did I meet the last time I saw you? Who was at the club?
I think you met Kissy.
That
yeah,
Kissy,
you met
right?
Kissy. You met Kissy.
She's a real sweetheart.
She's got an EP out mm-hmm. now called Real. And we got a Christmas project that's out. So she making a move, doing her thing. And I also got this young female artist by the name of Fly J.
Okay.
Like, she's really, 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 really dope.
How the hell are you staying so relevant? 20 years.
You got to know how to adapt.
You know, how do you got to adapt, but how are you keeping your finger, your thumb so much on the pulse to be able to stay relevant and to be able to adapt? Like, you know, are you studying music? Is it just
I'm gonna be honest.
Like, you know, is it just...
I'm gonna really be honest with you. I think it comes from being chosen, number one, and then I also think it just comes from.
Hey, we're going live.
Yeah, we're going live. I know I want to go live on that thing. Come on. Get that thing right there, so they
Boom.
See a bam.
Boom.
Let me see. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, but just, you know what I'm saying?
Got a lot of cameras around here, man.
Yeah, just, I think it's just, you know what I'm saying, just being in the midst,
mm-hmm.
you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Being in the midst and studying the game and just knowing what's hot, who's hot, keeping an open mind and just having that ear, you know what I'm saying, having that ear. And I've been blessed to, you know what I'm saying, be on that wave lift like mm-hmm. that, so, you know. I mean,
look at Dan, what's up, Danielle?
You know what I'm saying? And plus, I'm gonna be honest with you. I really pay attention to what be going on
mm-hmm.
out here.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I keep my eyes and my ears open to the street. So, yeah.
So, how often do you look for a new artist?
I don't look.
They just come to you.
It ain't even that. I let the opportunity present itself. I do have a lot of people that come to me. I do have a lot of people
mm-hmm.
that send music,
mm-hmm.
but I tell people.
Is that the way? Like, I mean, do you really sit? You don't really sit and listen to music.
No, I don't.
Right.
I'd be lying to you if I say I do.
I
do listen.
I don't. They say stuff all the time.
I listen very rarely.
Right.
Very rarely. But I like to see the movement
mm-hmm.
and see
mm-hmm.
people actually mm-hmm. doing something for themselves and making a person like me want to come to them or want to deal with them or want to get in, you know what I'm saying, business with them.
That's crazy. That's a good piece of advice. It's like, yo, you want somebody to take notice, go ahead and start your movement.
Yeah.
Go ahead and get consistent. Go ahead and put in the work, invest in yourself.
Exactly.
Before you come to, you know, oh, it's Silver play my song. Well, okay, I go to your page and it's one post. Or, you know, no movement.
And what the artists don't...
How can I do that? What can I do with that?
And what the art... Yeah, exactly. And what the artists don't understand is that everybody is not going to make it.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Like, you got so many people that are trying to rap. Everybody believing that they're a rapper
mm-hmm.
or they're a singer
mm-hmm.
or whatever, but...
And they the best.
Yeah. Everybody ain't going to make it.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
you gotta have something unique about yourself. You got to show me something
mm-hmm.
to make me believe that I should give you this opportunity or give you a chance for me to invest my time into you.
So, you know, I miss my brother Lo, man. He was so cool.
Oh, man.
How did y'all meet? How did that relationship, you know, kind of come? Because y'all were actually really good friends.
We were more than friends.
Brothers.
Brothers.
Yeah, yeah.
We was so close that even to this day, people be like, man, you look just like Shawty
mm-hmm,
Lo.
Mm-hmm.
Like, we started looking like each other.
I used to think y'all was brothers. Like, every time y'all came through the spot, I was like, they brothers?
Yeah, people actually, you know what I'm saying, say we look alike a lot. And
mm-hmm.
then we favor, you know, of course, because of the beard and everything. But
mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
I
mm-hmm.
had a real genuine love for Lo. And we had so much in common. He had 11 kids,
mm-hmm.
10 baby mamas.
Mm-hmm.
I had 10 kids, 8 baby mamas.
Damn. Oh, y'all fucking.
It's a story, bye-bye.
Shit.
But I'm going to tell you the unique thing on some real shit. I'm going to tell you the unique thing about that.
Mm-hmm.
Lo took care of all his,
mm-hmm.
you know what I'm saying? And he had a relationship with every last one of his kids' mom, which is ironic and crazy. And
people out here with one kid.
And can't even take care of him.
And they
can't even take care of him, but
right.
you know, Lo took.
How that camera doing over there? You are checked it?
All
right.
Lo took care of all his kids. I take care of all my kids.
Mm-hmm.
And like, we was really in our kids' lives. You know what
That's
I'm saying?
Dope.
He was really in the kids'
That's
life.
Dope. Let me get an applause real quick.
Yeah, yeah.
Now I got sauce on my board. Look.
Wow.
I ain't even gonna wipe it off.
But I had a lot of respect for Lo. I met Lo. Lo was actually locked up
mm-hmm.
when I started working with. Yeah, I'm gonna get one.
Wings,
yeah,
man.
You know I'm gonna
wings
get one though. he was locked up when we signed D4L. Mm-hmm. When I was at the radio station one day on Coco Brothers show. And
Back in the day.
You
see, I ain't thought about Coco in a minute.
Back in the day, people used to bring their CDs mm-hmm. up to the radio mm-hmm. station and wait mm-hmm. for mm-hmm. an artist or somebody mm-hmm. to come out so they can give their CD. And Moot B gave me this CD and said, look, man, you need to fuck with us. We the hottest thing on the west side and all this and that. And then I was like, okay. Mm-hmm. So I did not know that Lo was who he was. My partner, D-Money, mm-hmm. shouts out D-Money, which we in business, doing business again
to
now.
To this day?
Yeah, we back nice. In business. He signed my artist, Kissy Lee.
Thank you, M.
So, right yeah, there. I know, M on point.
M on point today. I need her every time I do a podcast, I need M, man.
M is on point. So D-Money was telling me, he was like, look.
Wait, I'm going to let you finish the story. But first, whiskey.
Uh-oh, shot of whiskey. This man gonna have me tore up before I leave. Let me get some more of my stomach.
The podcast is before whiskey. Somebody was asking. Yeah, man. It looks like Shawty Lo, the kid, got flavor. Bang head.
Yeah.
Being bullet cape. But yeah.
Y'all already
damn
know.
Right. But first whiskey. We on this son, Tory. Are you ready?
Another salute.
To another 20. And plus years of success.
Exactly.
And greatness.
Yes. Boom. All right, my boom. Man. Boom.
Cheers. Cheers. Am, you can't have one of these. You're on the clock.
Ah. Damn, that's New York. I can't even get it right now.
Well, I'm the end of your call, right?
Okay. He's just ended my call. He just took over my phone. He said, you on my podcast? I run all this right now.
I'm running this right now. Damn, it didn't get no easier. That second one I thought was gonna get a little smoother. It didn't.
Man, that's some good whiskey. Good whiskey.
Shout out to Uber and Lyft, our sponsors for the day.
I know that's right.
look, Johnny, I'm gonna get on you about yesterday. I'm gonna let you finish your story. I said, man, you know, when you get to the spot, you know, bring your ticket, you know, so you get validated. So you get validated. Johnny said, thanks, but Silv, I can pay for parking.
Yeah, I got money. You know what I'm saying? We do that. Hey, we still spending old money.
Today, Johnny's paying for everybody's parking in the building. You over there.
He's paying. This man right here is crazy.
It's the whiskey.
Oh, yeah, it's the whiskey.
All right, go. Keep going.
Yeah, so anyway, my man D-Money was telling me about.
D-Money.
He was telling me about Lo. He said, listen. The way I am on the east side, mm-hmm. that's how Lo is on the west side. Mm-hmm. Like, he about that life for real. And this is what he do.
Right.
You know, he made money in the streets and they did their thing. So I like, oh, okay. So I was talking to him on phone. And just to speed the story up, we had did the song Laffy Taffy. Mm-hmm. Well, actually, when they recorded, they told me to come to the studio. I listened to the song. I said, Laffy Taffy?
Yeah.
I said, what the hell is this? So we was like, I don't know about this. And I was talking to Lo on the phone. Mm-hmm. Lo was like, I don't know about that.
Right, I don't know about that.
We were all tripping on that first.
Right.
But when we pressed up, because we had the song, Bet You Can't Do It Like Me.
Yep.
So
when we was
pressing up the single and putting it out, mm-hmm. actually, Moot B had snuck the song in when we were pressing up. Back then, we used to do that guerrilla marketing. We mm-hmm, mm-hmm. press up a lot of mm-hmm. CDs, send them off and mm-hmm. all this and that. Man, he put that song on the CD.
Y'all didn't know the song was on
We didn't
there.
Even know the song was on the CD.
Wait. You telling me Laffy Taffy was a mistake?
Yeah.
One of y'all biggest records.
Biggest record.
Was a mistake.
And didn't even know. And that song blew up. Cause I remember like it was yesterday.
Wow.
A DJ called me from Nashville. And he was like, what's this other song? I got in an argument with the man saying, man, it's not another song on this CD. He said, yeah, if you go press number 5, I said, number the clean, dirty, instrumental, acapella. Cause back then we'll put all
right, four right, the, for the DJs right.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He said, man, press number 5. I'm saying, listen,
and
man.
And it was Laffy Taffy.
And we pressed up 10,000 of these CDs, right? And sent them off to different markets. So I went in the car. I pressed number 5. I said, how the fuck did this song get on here?
Moot B.
He asked me, could he play the song?
Moot B.
Asked me, could he play it? I said, I don't care. I promise you, I'm not lying. this song was an overnight, because everybody just started playing. The word traveled so fast, and people started playing it. And people just started asking about it.
You blowing my mind right now, man.
They were like, can you play that song, Laugh and Tap? And I think at that time, believe it or not, it was something that was so new.
Yeah.
And something that was just so different. People weren't used to that sound.
Right,
just, you know what I'm saying?
Right,
so they were requesting, asking about it. And it just, next thing I know, everybody just
look,
started
he dancing right now. You hear the song you hear right now. That's crazy.
Y'all going crazy, man. Hold up.
I told you, the Malaysian chili wings.
I'm going to have to come here and eat. Mm-hmm. I'm going to come here and eat, man.
We had Cole on Highland, you know. So we kick. What we eating? Okay, they want to know what we eating. So we have Malaysian chili wings.
Uh-huh.
This is the live right here, y'all. So everybody in the podcast, it's a live. Malaysian chili wings with the slaw. Mango summer rolls with the peanut sauce. The tiger. What's on the tiger roll? A lot of shit. It's good though. And we have the Thai. Give me that menu right there. Uh-oh. And the Thai salmon roll. So wait, what's on the tiger roll? Shrimp, cucumber, scallions, a bunch of shit that I can't pronounce. Avocado. It's good, man.
Yes,
it's really good. And we're drinking Suntory whiskey.
Yes,
that's what's going down.
Yes, we are.
That's what's going down. So now, tell me about this Young LA deal, man. That's the homie. Like, it's so funny. Everybody that you name, y'all used to come to Primetime religiously with me.
Yes, yes.
That was a spot, man.
LA, I miss Primetime.
I miss Primetime too. Why don't we put some money together and buy it? I want to buy it and reopen it. And do the same formula.
No, don't play with me now, because I'll call your bluff out on it.
I'm dead ass.
Looking to that now.
I'm dead ass serious. I've been talking about this for years.
We need to look into that.
Okay. All right. And we're going to do a documentary about it, too. I know you're going to be down.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. We'll talk off air about that.
Yeah. But Young L.A., mm-hmm. I've been knowing L.A. for a minute, mm-hmm. and I've been watching his grind. Watching everything that he ain't been through, mm-hmm. and you mm-hmm. know the ups and downs, mm-hmm. cause you mm-hmm. know ain't nothing always pretty mm-mm. all the way. If you don't mm-mm. go through, you know, say adversary and just trials and tribulation, then
that's the character
it's
of
not
a person,
no
right?
Success, yeah. Mm-hmm. So you know, watching. But recently, I seen LA, and I like LA. You look good. I like you look good. I like.
To have
I like this.
To have gone
LA.
Through all that.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And then I was like, you know what I'm saying, asking him what he doing and, you know, seeing where he was at. And then he hit me up, man. He was just like, look, he like, man, I always respected you always. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Respected your grind and your hustle and everything. I know we tried to hook up once before, but mm-hmm. stuff came, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying, up or whatever. But he was like, man, I need you right now. He was like, I want to fuck with you. And I like, shit, let's make it happen. You know what I'm saying? Let's do it.
People, so, I think people still love Young L.A., man.
Yeah. The man is talented.
Yeah.
So, you know, I decided to, you know what I'm saying, give him an opportunity, give him a chance. And I'm finna really, like, turn this man's life around.
Dope.
Like, we finna get to it for real, for real. So, shouts out to L.A.
Let me ask you something, man. But first of all, applause. We're gonna drop. Y'all can't hear the sound effects. We got all kinds of sound effects.
Yeah, we got all type of stuff, man. I'm gonna try this little roll
man.
Right here.
Man, try it. While you trying it out, I ask the next question.
Okay.
Okay, for you to have been in all these projects, big names, mm-hmm. big shit popping, how do you stay so grounded and so humble? You know, I know some people that ain't even did half of what you've done, even a quarter,
mm-hmm.
and they're fucking assholes. I'm just gonna say what it is. Why are you so cool? Why are you so humble? Every time I've called you, you've either picked up the phone, and this is from the beginning, Primetime days, to now. You've picked up the phone, or you've called me back, or you said, I'm going to hit you back, and you hit me back. From the jump.
Mm-hmm.
How do you stay so humble, so grounded, man? What's that? How?
I'm going to tell you the key thing.
Mm-hmm.
I knew what it took and how long and how much work and how much grind I had to put into this mm-hmm. to get to where I'm at.
Mm-hmm.
The same thing that got me here and put me where I'm at and gave me my name, I got to keep that going.
That's real.
You know what I'm saying? I got to keep that going.
That's real.
And I never want to forget the people that did help me along the way.
Mm.
So you have a lot of people, once they get to a certain status, mm-hmm. stop answering the phone. Mm-hmm. They don't pick up. And I hate that.
I get this so much right now.
You know what I'm saying?
They forget all the times they came and said, man, play my record. And I stopped what I was doing.
They would go Hollywood on you quick.
Real quick.
And I just hate the fact that people, you know what I'm saying, don't remember. It was the people that was right there on the ground level with mm-hmm. you, grinding it mm-hmm. out, supporting you, playing your records, giving you that opportunity mm-hmm. to come mm-hmm. to the club, and now you can't show no love back. You that high, you that big now, you can't pick up the phone, you can't give that person an opportunity, you can't give them a shout out or tell them thank you or whatever.
Not even a shoestring? I can't get a shoestring, Johnny?
I hate that.
I can't get a straw in my water, Johnny? God damn.
So, you know, I just always said I'm not trying to be a person like that.
Yeah. Well, God bless you, man. Listen.
So I just
that's why you're successful now. That's why people rock with you. And outside of everything else, I feel like it's the longevity.
Yeah.
That's why you're able to be here 20 years and we still looking good, still happy, stress-free.
Yeah.
Bills paid.
Yeah.
You know, relatively healthy, you know,
able to take care of all my kids.
Able
my
to
mom,
take care of all 20 kids.
Mom, I take care of a lot of people. I take care of a lot of people.
So, new artists, if they want to get at you, they got to have something going. They got to have something to bring to the table.
And I'm just going to keep it real. They can take it like how they want to take it. Mm-hmm. Got to have a budget.
Amen.
You got to have a budget. I'm just being real.
Can you say
it
a little louder for the people in the back and hear you?
You got to have a budget.
Ain't nothing free out here. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nothing free. Now, you got to have a budget.
That's
you know,
real.
If you're not willing to invest in yourself or if you don't believe that much in yourself to, you know what I'm saying, put the money behind you or find somebody to put the money behind you, then I don't know what it takes.
We were just talking about that. You was asking me, like, man, all this, like, y'all can't see all this that's going on behind and the pieces I've bought. He was like, man, well, you know what you, I started adding up in my head, like, wait, I done spent some money. But I don't think about it like that.
Yeah.
Because I look at, I'm hoping the bigger picture is so much worth it.
Exactly.
That's the point, you know?
Exactly.
That's the point. So, what's next? You got L.A., you got...
Man, I got L.A., I got, like I said, Kissy Lee, Fly. I'm really excited about Fly J. This
Fly
16-year-old girl, like her father...
She's a rapper, singer,
she's
both?
She's a rapper. She was on...
She produced, she playing the instruments?
Nah.
You know her?
Yeah, she was on the Rap Game. She was on American Got Talent.
She was the first rapper...
You know what I'm saying? That category to get the golden buzzer.
So now she's under your stamp.
Yeah.
Management.
Me and her mom.
You have a management and booking agent.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
And consulting.
That's a big one.
Yeah.
Consulting.
Yeah.
A lot of people need that.
They do, because they don't be having a clue.
At all.
They don't have a clue. Mm-hmm. So, you know, her mom, shout out to Kia Jones. Mm-hmm. You know, that's my partner right here, boy. That's my partner. But her dad was Camouflage, who was a big artist from Savannah, Georgia. He was signed to Universal.
Camouflage, man. R.I.P., right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I used to play the hell out of Camouflage.
Mm-hmm.
He have a song called Cut Friends?
Yep. Yep, was a hit. That was a hit song.
I used to play the hell out of that song.
That was a hit song. That was a hit song.
That's her pop.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I remember when he passed.
You that he blessed her with that talent because she is sick with it. Like, she's really sick. And the great thing about her, she don't curse. She don't, you know what I'm saying, be degrading, you know what I'm saying, the female or anybody.
She ain't
whatever.
Popping and twerking.
But her music, it make you feel like you listening to some cussing or you listening to this and that because of the way her delivery come and just the content of her words and stuff. She's so dope with it. You know, we just came back from New York doing this press run and it was crazy up there. It was crazy. But Fly J, she going to be real big. I got a dope roster. I ain't trying to be arrogant or bragging, but boy, in 2020, I'm bringing out them guns. Like, everybody's so unique.
As you should.
Everybody's so unique and dope in their way, from Fly J to Kissy Lee. To Kissy Lee, to Leighton Green, to Light Skin. Man, Light Skin Keisha grinding so hard and doing
much. That's under you as well?
Yes, yes. And she's already had some big shit coming 2020 that's about to be crazy. A lot of big shit that's popping.
I hear she needs a DJ, a tour DJ.
Well, I don't know, boy. Hey, which
kind of? I hear she's a DJ Silver Knight tour DJ. What's up, huh?
Hey, boy, Trey, he'll go crazy, boy.
She already got one. Okay, she already got one.
He'll go crazy. They got a nice little chemistry.
We're gonna figure it out.
Yeah, but
you see how I plug myself? Yes.
And then I got this group out of Memphis.
Boy,
I signed.
Shut your mouth.
Hey, I got this group out of Memphis. Some old females.
What's the name?
Trap Girls. 10K. Well,
you not playing?
Ice cream. Yeah.
You not playing?
Yeah, they doing their thing too. You know what I'm saying? So Trap Girls, I'm excited about them.
You got a recording studio as well.
You know what? I think I might get one 2020. Mm-hmm. I think I might get one.
I can put that together too.
Cause all my artists always wind up either having their own studio mm-hmm. or have a home that mm-hmm. they be at. But
it's good to have a space.
I think I might get me a studio space.
We need to talk about that too, cause I'm trying to get a space.
Okay.
For real.
Yeah, we're gonna mm-hmm. we definitely talk mm-hmm. about that. Definitely.
I want one in the city though. I want it nice.
Yeah. Gotta be nice.
Well, we can not only record music, but do stuff like this too.
Exactly.
You know.
Exactly.
It's a nice space.
So you know, everybody that I have is doing their thing. Also, Crime Mob. You know, we coming back out.
You know,
strong
I love
2020.
Them. You know, I love Crime Mob.
Listen, Crime Mob.
I love them.
It's the reason why I am here today.
Speak on it.
They are the reason. They were the first group that really gave me my full opportunity and put me in the position to where I'm able to be Johnnie Cabbell. I was
love
just
it.
Johnnie. Yeah. But you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Johnnie Cabbell,
yeah.
I got to give shots out to Crime Mob. You know what I'm saying? Because,
applause.
Man,
applause
we did
right
so
now.
Much. I used to be the manager, the security,
yep.
the DJ,
yep. Yep.
the booking agent. I damn near with the hype man on the stage,
yep,
too.
Yep,
but, you know,
yep.
they really gave me an opportunity. And shout out to their parents because their parents trusted in me and they believed in me and they gave me that chance. And I was able to walk into a real situation.
Because
before they got their deal, I became their manager and we was able to get a real situation with Warner Brothers everything took off. And that what really like put me in the game. Cause I was able to start meeting real people.
Yeah, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I was around real things that I used to dream of, the BET.
Cause it was through the roof.
The 106 and Park and all that. There was stuff I used to look at and be like, damn.
Yes.
Now I'm actually around it.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? I'm meeting all these big DJ. I'm meeting the radio personality. I'm meeting the PDs and all that. So it was like, that was up. That was up.
That's dope,
I think it's
man.
Time for another whiskey shot.
You think so?
I think so. Hey, I just felt it for some
reason. Am.
Am, where you at,
Am? Where you at, Am?
We need your help, Am.
We need you, Am.
We got another shot request.
Real quick, sorry.
Another shot request.
But you got to set it up. See,
yeah.
See the hard part about the name But First Whiskey is setting up how you say it. So it's like, you know what? I'm going to let you finish your story, but first.
Yes.
You got to set it up the right way. So it's like, you know.
Before I go any further.
See how hard it is?
Yes.
See? It's hard. It's hard to set it up.
Let's just take a little whiskey break.
No. You got to say, you know what? I got one more question before we go. But first, whiskey.
Hell yes.
I've been practicing
whiskey,
how to set up.
Whiskey,
whiskey, whiskey.
Oh, look at him with the little ice cubes. Oh, that's cute.
Oh, okay.
That is cute.
Now, she didn't have to do that, and that's what you call initiative and effort right there.
You see what I'm saying? I needed her yesterday.
I mean, come on.
Look at that. Now, I was just about to say, listen, do not swallow the ice cube.
I'm going to try not to.
He killed Johnny. No.
You killed Johnny.
Listen, oh, that would be so awful. And you know what the fucked up part is? I'll still put the episode out and be like, RIP, I loved him. He came. Okay.
Hey. With you saying that, I definitely, you know what I'm saying, just want to have a quick moment silent for my man Juice WRLD that passed away.
Yes, man.
And I want to touch on that subject. I want to touch on that subject.
So the reports are coming out, and it's...
It's sad, but let's toast to Juice WRLD.
Juice WRLD, man. Juice WRLD, my brother Lo.
Yeah, Lo. And all the great ones we didn't lose.
All of them, for real. That was the roughest one.
That was good.
The ice cube. Oh,
I think I'm about to be turned out on whiskey. Oh, I'm coming alcoholic.
Now keep in mind, we are drinking at 11 o'clock in the morning.
You know, I just realized that. I got the whole day ahead of me. Oh, Lord, I'm going to be messed up. Oh, Lord, have mercy.
Nephew, you good?
Let me ask you a question, Silver Knight.
Talk to me.
And I want you to keep it honest and keep it real. And the reason why I'm asking you this question is because you are a DJ.
Mm-hmm.
You play a lot of music.
Yeah.
I know. Do you ever think about the content of the music that you're playing? Do it ever come into a consideration of what you're playing?
And you talking to me personally?
Yeah, yeah. I really want to know because I'm going to ask you why I'm asking you that question.
Well, I'm going to tell you the real. It's a lot of shit I don't play, depending on what they're talking about. Like, there was a song, and I think he's actually in jail for killing somebody. It was like, murder on my mind, murder, that bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
Never played it once. There's certain things that I just do not play. I don't give a damn. I don't care how hot it is. I don't play it.
Okay.
But I've gotten to a point where I can do that.
So
you know what I mean?
So let me ask you this. Do you play Future?
Some of it.
Interesting.
Some.
Okay.
Some.
Okay.
Not all. I've played. Now, I'll be honest with you. I ain't played Future in a long time. But when it was like hot like fish grease,
mm-hmm.
I was playing some of the radio singles. Now, some of that I had to play.
Okay.
Some of it you had. Something that big, I have to play.
How do you feel about the artist that praises and talk a lot about these different drugs like Zans and Lean?
I hate it.
And all that.
I hate it. Now, I love me a good whiskey, but we not overindulging in this bullshit. First of all, I hate the message that it sends to the kids that aren't strong enough to have a mind of their own. Some of these kids and people are just followers out mm-hmm. the gate. They're not strong, so they're looking at us.
You right, and I was listening to an interview that Juice WRLD had
mm-hmm.
before he passed,
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
he was like, I got on Lean and stuff by listening to Future because it was like, they were just talking about it, and you know.
You about to make me stop playing all his shit, because I see where you're going with it. We have a responsibility.
You're right. Now
we have a deeper responsibility. I see where you're going with that.
I just feel like, you know, because he said when you in
I'm about
sixth,
to be ghetto and not when, use these chopsticks.
When you in the sixth or seventh grade, that's when you really finding yourself and finding what you want to do and all this and that. Mm-hmm. And he was like.
And they idolize these people.
Yeah, they do.
They like really, that's their God.
And it really made me think about something because now I'm finna have to go back.
Because
I have teenagers now.
Mm-hmm.
I got five girls and I have five boys. A lot of my kids are like 13 and up. So now I'm going to have to really talk to them and look at the type of music they listening to and what they really, you know what I'm saying, up on. Because it's like, I don't want that to steer my child into a different direction and take them off course of what they really trying to do.
And they got more access. Not to call myself old, but I got a couple years. We got a couple years, right? Yeah.
And we got to start taking accountability as parents.
Yes.
And adults.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
But they have more access. The internet is so wide open to see so much shit that I couldn't
see. You're right.
Like, I used to try to... This is crazy. I'm about to tell y'all some dumb shit. I just thought about what I'm about to tell you. So I used to try to watch the cable channel so they would scramble and try to. I think it's a nipple. But you know, now you see any and everything on the internet with just a click of a button, man.
Right.
Everything. You could see the first time I've seen somebody for real killed was on the internet, on like Facebook or Instagram. It's the craziest shit.
Crazy.
What they have access to now.
Right.
How you doing? Hi. All right. Welcome in the cold.
What are you shooting?
We're just shooting a little podcast. There's nothing going on. Drinking a little whiskey, eating a little food.
Having a fabulous time right now.
I'm so bootleg. This is so bootleg, Johnnie.
Somebody said, hold on. Don't put all this on one artist's self-destruction culture as lived in hip-hop.
Who's that?
That's gangsta rap.
Oh, who's that? Odell?
Odell.
Is that comedian?
Yeah, that's comedian Odell.
My dog. Okay.
That's comedian Odell.
No, we're not saying it's all on one, but we're just saying there's a responsibility. Even then, you're absolutely right. There was a responsibility, but so here's the thing. Gangster rap was a reflection of what was going on in their neighborhood, right?
Mm-hmm.
these pills, I guess it's a reflection, but damn, I mean, to put that on in the culture like that, on such a broad scale, for these kids to see, I think we do have a more responsibility with that versus the gangster rap.
It is a responsibility, and I think we need to step up as, you know, concerned parents, yes, as responsible adults, and as business owners. And like, we talk about, you know, what a kid shouldn't do and this and that, but yet and still, we still promote certain things and we still allow certain things to happen as far as certain music to be put out there and certain people to, you know, do what they do. So I just feel like everybody got to be held accountable and be responsible for what we actually doing. Because if we're going to ever try to change it or change the course of what's going on, we got to start making change ourselves.
Well, and more importantly, to your point, okay, reality is reality. There's going to be people, like you said, gangster rap. Yeah. There's going to be people popping pills or whatever. It's the responsibility of teaching the kids, right?
Yeah.
Hey, it's okay. It's okay. You seeing this? We're not gonna hide this truth from you. But that whiskey kicked.
Got take the jacket out now. I'm trying to support lifestyle, but boy, now for the support another brand. This is Kissy Lee brand. Fetch. That's
nice.
Our brand.
Nice. I like it. But I think the most important part is teaching the kids. No matter what the reality is or what's going on in the world is gonna be the world. It's teaching the kids.
Mm-hmm.
Teaching the youth, teaching those that don't know. There's two sides to this story. Yeah, there is a side where, you know, the pills and alcoholism and, mental health, all these things. Mm-hmm. But there's two sides. Teach them. If you don't, that's, you got to learn, right?
Yeah.
You know, you don't want to hide the truth. So, yeah, you know, there's the futures, there's the, you know, the juice worlds and different people. But also there's the other side, too.
Matt Miller.
Teach him.
Yeah.
Teach him. Matt, right, teach him. Well, somebody says something. What? I like that. Go. I'm going to have to start live and scroll back down a little bit.
Different generation.
Scroll back down. So we're on Instagram Live, and we're about to start taking questions. Hold up. What's this say? What's that one say? I can't read that because it's blocking in our community against.
Because that whiskey didn't kick in.
Of violence in our community against
each other.
Yeah. It's education. It's education.
Action.
Yeah. It's education. What OD say?
May the powers that have realized how
influential music is to us and begin to leverage it.
Oh yeah. It's another way to trap us, of course. They're gonna use what they can.
Yeah.
Yeah. But we done got deep.
Yeah.
It ain't supposed to be this deep on this podcast. My podcast is supposed to be drinking whiskey and eating sushi.
Yeah, but we just had to address that.
But that's real. But that's real.
Because that man was 21 years old.
21.
Just think how his parents is feeling. His mom, his dad, his friends, sister, his brother, the fans.
The fans are crushed, man.
You know what I'm saying? Because Juice WRLD was really, really popular. Like, he was signed to the label that I'm very good friends with. My man, Joey, i.e., you know what I'm saying, that's over at Interscope and all that. Mm-hmm. And I knew the management and the team that was working with Juice WRLD. So, you know, like, my condolences out to everyone because we lost another good one. And, you know, Matt Miller and what was his name? Triple X? Extension.
I've always mispronounced.
Like, we lost a lot of young people. You know what I'm saying? Like
21, 20s.
Yeah, like these people ain't reaching to see 25 or, you know what I'm saying? Getting 21 and getting just taken out. That's why a lot of people, I'm glad people call me an OG.
Yeah.
Glad.
He was young. He just turned 21,
I'm
man.
I'm glad I'm the age
Lil
that
Pete,
I am.
Lil Peep.
All these young people that just passing away out here, you know. So it's a blessing to be where I'm at. Like, I didn't see
I like this comment. Willie Lynch, stop separating the old and the young. That's it.
Yeah.
You need your OGs, man.
Yeah.
You need your OGs. You're right. They'll tell you you don't. You need. I still need my OGs.
You got to.
And I'm an old motherfucker.
I need to get one of these.
Which one?
Okay. I'm going to get this one right here.
Man, we're going to wrap this thing up.
It feel like we just got started.
Man, I want to be irresponsible and do one more whiskey before we go.
Yeah, let's do that.
We're gonna end it on a half shot. Okay, we're gonna end this. We're gonna end this show. But first, whiskey.
Exactly.
I meant to hit the other button. Run it, man. Yeah, Ice Cube. Yeah, the Ice Cube was clutch.
Yeah, this is the Ice Cube.
Yeah. Before we do that, tell them how they can get at you. Let's say an artist really want to get at you. What's the
you
best
can follow,
way?
Look, follow to get me at on Johnnie. My IG, Johnnie Cabbell, J O H N N I E C A B B E L L. Johnnie Cabbell. I'm gonna say it again.
They gonna jump in your DMs.
N N I E C A B B E L L.
Say it one more time.
J O H N N I E C A B B E L L.
Okay. And that's Instagram.
No. That's Instagram. Mm-hmm. And Twitter is JCHAH. And my Facebook is Johnnie Cabbell.
Okay. And they can reach out to you.
Reach out to me.
If they got a movement really hot, you're willing to look at it.
Yeah, I'm willing to look at it.
If they got a budget, you're willing to consult.
If you have a budget, then that puts you ahead of the game.
Say it again.
That gets you a meeting quick.
Say it one more time.
Get you a meeting real quick.
No, the first
budget. Part. Budget.
Can you
budget.
Spell that? Can you spell?
B-U-D-G-E-T. B-U-D-G-E-T.
Say it for the people across the street.
B-U-D-G-E-T. Budget. But if you get your budget, and you really trying to see your career go to that next level, then definitely DM me, get at me, and we can make some things happen. I can't save the world, but if it's meant for you, then it's gonna be for you. Mm-hmm. You know,
because how many artists do you have right now?
Light Skin, Keisha, Layton, Kissy Lee, Trap Girls, Fly J,
LA,
Silver
Knight. Silver Knight.
Hey, we might talk about it.
Silver Knight.
Hey. I don't think I ever had a DJ that.
Well, you know, I make music too. So DJ, producer, artist,
and you got this great podcast,
you know what I'm saying? Host, personality.
So when you bring two great energies together, it just makes it even bigger and better.
Yes.
We might have to talk about that, Silver Knight.
Listen, I'm with it.
Silver Knight,
I'm with it.
And you, I mean, you know what?
I can honestly say
that you always been real.
Thank you.
And you've always been consistent.
Thank you.
Which is a key thing, consistent. Gotcha. You know what I'm saying?
That's the Malaysian wings, ladies and gentlemen.
You've been consistent, and I like the fact that you haven't changed up. Because you know y'all DJs change up too now.
Some of them.
Let's keep it real
some
now.
Some of them terrible.
You know what I'm saying?
Some of them terrible.
Y'all
DJs
would switch up on them.
Some of them that Hollywood with me. With me.
You know what?
With me.
I never thought about that. Do y'all DJs
they get Hollywood with me
within their own little mix?
Of course.
How do you deal with that?
I pray, I drink a whiskey, and I try not to kill these niggas.
Let's take a drink of that. Let's take a drink of that.
I don't want to kill them.
I just want to let you know that Silver Knight has officially got me twisted in the morning. Oh, Lord.
Nephew, I love you, man. You got to go? Oh, yeah, we done.
Oh, yeah, I want to give a shout out to my boy, No Way. He an independent artist.
Okay.
He's out here really grinding. This man still have a nine.
Hip-hop, R&B?
No, he rap.
Okay.
But his music is he make good music. Mm-hmm. And he's been grinding. My son, who's in the game and trying to break his way in, he manages him.
Dope.
And they really, he really make
great
music.
Your son is managing as well?
Yeah. Yeah, he followed into his dad's footsteps.
That's big.
So, you know, shout out to No Way, man. Shout out to No Way. He got this single out with the Reds to Sean, man. He's making noise, doing this thing out there. And this man been making hits. And this is a prime example of what I take. Like, even my own son, I do not let it just come easy like that. I tell him, you got to put in your work.
Yeah.
I told him, damn right. Even your artists that you have, they got to invest, and they got to be willing to put in. This man, you know, is really trying to invest and put a lot into himself, and he's trying to find his way and make his way. Sometimes the artists don't understand how hard it be. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. To really get on. But mm-hmm. I'm letting him go through everything he need to go through as a man.
Yeah.
A business person, yeah, and being someone that's, yeah, in this industry, so he can never say that my dad just handed it to me on the silver platter.
Damn right.
You know what I'm saying?
That's
so
big, man.
You know, I'm letting him go through it. Like, I could, yeah, easily say,
right,
get behind, be like, oh, we finna take, ooh, nah, I ain't doing it.
Well, you set him up for the future.
Exactly.
You setting him up.
Exactly.
And setting him up for when he started having kids, how to set them up. You're teaching.
Yeah.
That's important.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Johnnie Cabbell.
Hey, Johnnie Cabbell, Johnnie Cabbell. Man, I had a pleasure, man. Been, hey, we got to do this again. We got to do a part two.
Hey, we're doing part two?
Part two, because it's so much we didn't get into.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
much.
I'm with it.
But this is dope. This is dope.
We could do it next week, man.
Yeah, we could do it next week. Hey, it don't matter. You just hit me up. I'm going to pick up my phone.
And he's real. Let me tell you, that I'm serious. You cut it off? Yeah. It cut off? Oh, that's fine. You got this one still going?
You might cut it back on real
quick. Oh, fuck it, man. We good. When did you cut it off?
Right when after you said Johnnie Cabbell.
Oh, that was good. That's good. We can talk. Because I'm
sure. Saucy. Cool.